Sir, since we are talking about flexible learning, may you expound more on this, sir? You said this is the pressing issue ngayon. So you said last week, sir, that flexible learning will be the new norm and it will continue even after pandemic. Why can't we resume po sa face-to-face learning? And how does flexible learning can be done, sir?
What is difficult for me to understand or what is alarming is that we have been doing face-to-face for 1 year now. And it seems that many still don't understand the definition of face-to-face or of flexible learning. Or worse, some refuse to understand it because they have a political agenda to push for. That is what is alarming. Flexible learning is very simple. It is a policy where you allow the universities the authority to determine the correct mix of delivery systems. Appropriate, number one, to the condition on the ground, what is the health condition? Number two, to the condition of the students and faculty members and employees. Okay. Number three, to the condition of connectivity and gadgets. And let them mix and match the various options. Flexible learning is not equal to distance or online education. As those who are agitating the students are saying, hindi equivalent yan. Online education is one type, only one type of flexible learning. There are many other types. You can combine online and offline. Synchronous and asynchronous, yan ang tawag nila. You can do it offline by giving modules to the students to do at home and submit it if these are areas where there is absolutely no connectivity. You can even do online and face-to-face like what is happening now in medical programs. Yung mga skills-based laboratory, face-to-face yan. We have authorized more than 60 schools to have face-to-face for laboratory classes because you cannot teach that virtually. You know, you cannot dissect. You cannot stitch the wound of a patient online. Or for dentists, you cannot fill cavities or extract a tooth by watching it online. And therefore, the correct mix will be decided by the schools in consultation with students, parents, local governments. I don't know what is so difficult to understand on that definition. So sabi nila, sinabi ko daw, imposibleng nang magkaroon ng face-to-face. I never said that. It was a 20-minute talk. They spliced one sentence out of the 20 minutes. And there are now some people who want to become famous who are accusing me of negligence. You know? Like what is being done in medical programs. The students will have face-to-face for skills-based courses. Now, if this works in medical and allied health, if the data on the ground says the students are not getting infected, I will now go to the president and recommend the next batch. Engineering, information technology, maritime programs, industrial tech. If the evidence on the ground says so, we have to do evidence-based decision-making. Kasi yung mga yon, kagaya ng maritime, pag hindi mo alam paan da rin yung barko, eh baka maibangga mo yan. You have to use the simulator. You have to use the computers. So, will there be face-to-face in the future? It depends on the conditions on the ground. Eventually, if we achieve herd immunity, vaccinated na 70%, okay. Then we will allow the schools to slowly bring back the students. But it will not be anymore in the old traditional type. That is what I meant. We have to retrofit the schools. Make sure hand washing becomes a practice of every student. Directional signs, airflow, okay? The cafeteria, the other facilities, the library. So that if the students come back, we assure everyone they are safe. You know, government will not allow if the health of the students, the faculty, and the administrators are not assured. When will this be? It will depend on conditions. Remember, even the best countries all over the world who opened schools have closed it. Because may variants yung pandemic eh. So close ulit sila. They figure out again. If things improve, they will open it again. That's what we're doing in the Philippines. Looking at how things are developing. Because the variants can come in. Our medical doctors here are the best experts. Padami ng padami yung variants kung saan-saan ang gagaling. We have to make sure our facilities are COVID resilient. And if that is the case, if they are COVID resilient, we will allow face-to-face. That is the policy of government. So I ask those who are spreading fake news and wrong information and agitating the students to lose face or to lose their belief in flexible learning, please stop. You are not doing anyone a favor. Our students are suffering enough from a lot of things that are beyond their control. Please do not let them suffer by spreading wrong information and agitating them. That is my only request. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Chairman De Vera. So we should fight against infodemic.